February 19, 1970, Commissioner Bowie Kuhn announces the suspension of Detroit Tigers ace Denny McLain, effective April 1st, for McLain's alleged involvement in a bookmaking operation. The suspension will last 3 months, setting off what will basically be a lost season for the two-time Cy Young Award winner.
Mr. McLain's involvement in 1967 bookmaking activities leaves me no alternative but to suspend him from all organized baseball activities.
The Commissioner of Baseball, in his divine wisdom, suspended me for 3 months.
McLain won 92 games for the Detroit Tigers from 1966 to 1969. 31 of those victories were in 1968, the magical year when Detroit won the World Series. He completed 28 games and pitched 336 innings that season.
Sure, I think I'm the best pitcher in baseball. If I didn't think so, I wouldn't be winning.
September 14th, a bright, sunny Saturday afternoon. Denny McLain attempting to become the first 30-game winner in more than 30 years.
The Diz was on hand for number 30. I won that one from the dugout. The A's had a 4-3 lead going into the bottom of the ninth.
Outfield is shallow, the pitch. Fastball, great shot!
February 1970, Sports Illustrated published an article about McLain's involvement in bookmaking activities. Sports Illustrated cited sources who alleged that the foot injury suffered by McLain late in 1967 was caused by an organized crime figure who stomped on McLain's foot as punishment for failing to pay off on a lost bet.
What hogwash that was. I screwed up my foot all by myself. I dozed off one night watching The Untouchable. When I got up, my foot was still asleep and I wrenched it, getting off the couch. Honest to God, that is the truth. Thanks to Sports Illustrated, my phone started ringing off the hook. J. Edgar Hoover's boys got to me first. The feds confirmed exactly what we suspected. Technically, I was not a bookmaker. I was only guilty of trying to be a bookmaker.
Mr. McLain's involvement in 1967 bookmaking activities leaves me no alternative but to suspend him from all organized baseball activities.
1970 was the beginning of the end for McLain. He won 3 and lost 5 that year. After the season, he was traded to the Washington Senators. In 1971, he lost 20 and won 10. He was traded to Oakland in 1972 and finished his career in Atlanta that same year. Denny would be sentenced to prison twice, first in 1985 for 23 years. That sentence was overturned when it was ruled that he did not get a fair trial. He was imprisoned again in 1996. He served 6 years of an 8-year sentence for conspiracy and money laundering. Does Denny belong in the Hall of Fame? His pitching stats from 1966 to 1969 say that he does. In those years, he won 92 and lost 45. Just on his 31 victory season alone, he deserves recognition. I admit, though, that I am a big McLain fan. He was the best ever in 1968 and 1969.